So when you look at prostate cancer and you look at how this prostate cancer affects you, it's important to know your risk of prostate cancer. So in general, about 80% of prostate cancers, are localized to the prostate. So if you take a prostate gland, meaning there's a cancer there, but all the cancer is contained within this prostate. It hasn't spread to other areas. So most prostate cancers are localized. That plays into treatment as well, because if a cancer is localized to one area, now there's all different types of treatments that can be done, including surgery, radiation, focal treatment, even active surveillance and watching prostate cancer as possible. Most of these cancers are localized and able to be treated. So when you look at risk of prostate cancer, just looking at your biopsy gives you so much information. Your biopsy report from your prostate biopsy will show you two important factors. One is it will show you your Gleason score, which translates into your risk of cancer. And the other thing it will show you is the volume of cancer, or how many cores were positive for cancer. So those are two important things seen on that biopsy. So when you talk about low risk prostate cancer, these are the Gleason 6 cancers. Most of these cancers are watched or observed very carefully with active surveillance. You don't just not watch them. What you do is you in fact watch that patient closer to make sure that Gleason 6 is not becoming bigger or changing, or it's not advancing into a more aggressive type of cancer. So that's low risk Gleason 6. In the middle is intermediate risk. And these are your Gleason 7s. Whether it's a 3+4, which is favorable, or a 4+3, which is unfavorable, if you have a Gleason 7 cancer, you're in this intermediate risk category. High risk. These are Gleason 8, 9, and 10 cancers. And these tend to be the more aggressive types of cancers, the high-risk ones. But everyone that is diagnosed with prostate cancer will be somewhere on this spectrum. Here, here, here. Everyone is different. The chart even expands greater, because high-risk can also now be metastatic, or actual known spread of cancer from the prostate to lymph nodes or other areas of the body. And so when there's metastatic disease, typically system-wide treatment is needed, because now you can't just treat the prostate, you need to treat the entire body and the entire area so that all areas of cancer are treated. So when there's spread of cancer, that's usually done with prostate cancer with what's called ADT. ADT stands for androgen deprivation therapy. And what that does is lowers the testosterone. So fuel for this cancer is testosterone. So if we can lower the testosterone, we can stop the fuel that allows this cancer. And guys, with this treatment alone, their cancer is usually stopped or suppressed, or the cancer stops growing. Now, there are side effects to androgen deprivation. Any type of treatment, whether it's medication or surgery or even observation, there's what's called risks, benefits, and alternatives. Everything has a risk, benefit, and alternative. And these medications or surgery that can be done for ADT, it all has a balance. And you have to balance out the treatment, the benefit, and weigh out the risks. And some of these risks with medicines that lower the testosterone, they can be fairly significant. So it's something to be aware of, that if you have metastatic disease and you're being put on a medicine that lowers your testosterone, you may have some side effects. Side effects which for some people and most people is tolerable, but you may notice some side effects with that. You also have to realize there's a big difference between a guy that has Gleason 6 and has metastatic cancer. These guys can be watched and monitored, and these guys, their mortality rate is fairly significant. So, you know, there's just a big difference. And this is one of those things with prostate cancer that makes prostate cancer unique. There's so many different ways people present, and there's so many different treatment options for all these different types of presentations that patients have. So that's what makes prostate cancer unique. That's why there's so much information about prostate cancer, because there's so many different treatments, so many different treatments. And that's what makes it tough for guys to make a decision. Oftentimes, is there's just so much that can be done, which can make it tough to come up with a decision. So much of it depends on where you are in this spectrum as to what kind of treatments you are going to have going forward. But that's a basic talking about risk, Gleason score, and then briefly discussing testosterone and the medications and the surgery that can be done to lower the testosterone so that there's no fuel for that prostate cancer. So I'm Dr. William Stiles, urologyanswers.com. Thanks for watching.